What is going on, fam? How you guys doing? I hope you guys are having a beautiful, blessed day. Tonight, I'm joined by my man, MOE SARGI.
What up, guys?
And we're actually at one of the most haunted hotels in California, in Santa Paula, in...
Santa Paula, California.
Why is that funny?
This place is not funny. This place is terrifying.
We are in Santa Paula, California. We're laughing because we keep stumbling on our words in this place. It's weird.
We're staying at like one of the most haunted rooms, room 307.
Yep, we're gonna be sleeping the night there. It's gonna get really scary tonight.
I'm actually terrified because I'll tell you more about the story, more about the historical property, and it is terrifying as I go along in the video. With that being said, smash the like button and let's go on with this video. Let's go. Guys, a little history, a little facts. I'm gonna read a couple facts about this hotel that we're actually staying in, which is terrifying. I actually saved it in my notes. One of the world's most negative haunted places, and it's the room 307. That's where we're staying tonight. A cowboy was killed, was shot in the head in room 307, and that's where we're staying. We're staying in room 307. And also a prostitute was beheaded inside the closet of room 307. And we checked in, we took a little tour of the place. That place is terrifying. When you get bad vibes as soon as you walk inside. So we're actually staying at one of the world's most haunted, like, yo, I'm so excited. This is gonna be an epic video. Like, smash the like button, like, subscribe to the channel if you're new. I got my man MOE SARGI. We decided to split for like just a quick second. This whole place is like completely dead, and for us to get a chance to stay at room 307 where there was a cowboy shot in the head and a prostitute was beheaded inside our closet that we're staying in tonight. This place was not only a hotel, it was a brothel and a gambling site at one point. And there's been many fights, many killings, many murders, many prostitutes being beheaded, but our room is the most haunted, room 307. And why is it most haunted? Because there was two killings inside that room, none other than the beheaded of the prostitute and the cowboy being shot in the head. Recently, Ghost Adventures did an episode here, and on the second floor, they recently discovered somebody checked in to the room and committed suicide. That is no joke, guys. If you're going through any bad thoughts and if you're feeling negative, there's always help. I'm gonna leave a link in the description below for a suicide hotline. So if you're going through some negative thoughts, make sure to there's always help. You don't talk to somebody, talk to me. I'm here for you. Well, I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna go show you guys the room and the hotel and everything, so stay tuned. Room 307, here we go. You go first, Mo.
Oh boy, this gives me the heebie-jeebies just because I've seen this exact same room on Ghost Adventures.
Yeah.
This is the haunted room. This right here is where two people were murdered in the past. A really long time ago, a cowboy was shot in the head here, and a prostitute was murdered, and her body was placed in the closet. Whoa, what the hell?
What was that?
I just got the weirdest shock touching that doorknob. What on earth?
How creepy. Can you imagine like someone being beheaded and thrown inside that closet?
So somebody was actually beheaded inside of this closet here at one point in time. A female, she was a prostitute. Doesn't mean you're supposed to behead prostitutes. You know, they're humans just like anybody else. I feel a weird presence in this closet right now.
Mo, quick question. Did we close the door?
Did we close the door? I don't remember you were in last.
Did I leave the door open? I'll review my footage.
I wonder if there's like...
I'm gonna close it now.
So when they found the female's body, I've seen pictures of it. I don't want to show it in my video. I want to be monetized. And they found a female's body. Blood everywhere.
Yo.
Do you have a DNA flashlight?
I should have one.
Let's take a look in the closet and see what we can find.
You want to look inside the closet with the black light?
This carpet looks very old to me. And look over here. If you look over here on the walls, there's some red stains over here. I don't know what that red stain could be, but maybe a DNA flashlight will show us.
Okay, right? We gotta turn off all the lights. All right, let's do it. Here's a DNA flashlight.
Oh, look at that, I was right. No.
Yeah, there's so Whoa. Many splatters on the door.
Yeah, oh shit, what happened? I didn't even turn off the light. What the hell was that? The light won't turn on.
Hey, yeah.
Oh, there we go. It turned off by itself, Joey.
That was crazy.
There's
never done that.
Weird splatter on the door over here. Let's follow the trail. Does it go up?
Check the doorknob. Maybe something around the doorknob?
No, it's just there's weird splatter. As you guys can see, this flashlight will show human DNA. Bro, this flashlight just shut off by itself.
Get out of here, bro. Are you messing with me?
No, no, bro. It shut off. Is the battery charged?
Yeah, it's brand new. I just like... Yo, point it to the ground? I think there's splatters on the... Whoa!
Oh my god.
Yo.
You guys, look. Look at this. There is some weird... See, this doesn't show up unless you're using this this type of flashlight. And look at this. There's DNA all over the carpet. If we turn on a flashlight... Oh. What's going on with this?
Bro. What happened to the light? Why did it turn...
Oh, it keeps shutting off by itself, dude. There's something here. I'm feeling a presence right now.
But why is it so cold in here?
It won't even turn on anymore. Look. There we go. Turns on.
Bro, is that a handprint?
I don't know if that's a handprint, but there are a lot of DNA stains in the closet. If I turn on my flashlight here, would that show?
No.
I don't see nothing.
Yeah, it's nothing.
Hmm. So what...
Did you just hear that? That sounded like a laugh, bro.
Yeah, I heard that. Hello, are there any spirits with us? Do you want to communicate with us today? Hey, Joey, look what I spotted here on the carpet.
What?
There's a red stain here.
Oh, man. There's a couple.
Look.
There's a couple red stains.
Red stain here and a red stain here. There is no way this is still the original carpet.
And there's like red spots here.
There's no way they didn't clean this up, dude. This hotel looks very, very clean. I'm almost worried to check the bed. We should check the bed.
You want to check the bed?
We should check the bed because we are going to be sleeping in it. And if there is blood residue on the bed, that is traumatizing.
Oh, this whole place is traumatizing. Bro, what the hell is that?
What?
Right here. Turn off.
Oh, what the hell? Wait, what is that?
What is that, bro?
I have no idea what that is.
Yo, what the hell is that? Someone's just hissing.
Hello? Stay very quiet.
Yo. Oh, never mind.
Huh? What was that?
I don't know, something was hissing.
Okay, hissing aside, I'd really like to know.
Candle wax?
Yeah.
Why would candle wax illuminate?
I don't know, but this is candle wax. Look at this. So, this isn't blood over here. This is candle wax. Look, there's red candle wax over here, so... We kind of just debunked this whole thing over here. That's not blood. At least I don't think that's blood. That's red candle wax. And this on the ground here, I'm willing to bet you is candle wax as well.
Yeah, probably.
Actually, there's no wax there.
Not that
this
one.
Over here. That looks like a burn. What is going on in this place? Yeah, but look over here, dude. You can see that splatter that we seen with the night light. Here, turn on your light again.
Bro, it was just on.
Why won't it turn on now?
Bro, I'm tripping.
What is going on? That thing was working perfectly fine earlier. It won't turn on? Okay.
Yeah.
See, that splatter, that's not wax, and we can't see that when we turn on the light. But it's here. It's here. It's evident all over the doors. I don't know.
Bro, it looks like a crime scene in here.
I wonder if we can lift up the carpet. Yo, Mo.
Huh?
I just lift up the carpet a little bit, and there's more of that.
Turn off the light. So turn off the light so we can see. Oh, that's my light.
I wonder if it...
Put that back.
Yeah,
I'm going to change the carpet. So this is room 307.
Bro, my light keeps turning off.
So this is room 307, and we are going to be spending the night here today. I'm getting some very, very, very strong, strong vibes in this room. I don't know what it is. It could be spiritual. It could be... I don't know what to say, because I was feeling top notch when we got here, but the second we got into the room, I'm beginning to feel some type of entity. Do you think those guys are gone downstairs?
I hope.
Running this new version of the spirit box called the Necrophonic. Basically, it minuses out the annoying white noise from spirit boxes. We will be doing a proper spirit box video in here. But we've been getting a lot of voices on the microphone. We heard leave 4 times in a row.
Back to back.
Hello, are there any spirits in this room with us?
You say yeah.
I heard a hi. What is your name?
Ethan, I heard Ethan. I definitely heard Ethan.
Was there ever a cowboy in this room that got shot? Was that a woman's voice?
That was a woman's voice.
A woman screaming? Did you die in the closet? Were you decapitated in this closet? I heard me too. Hello, we're trying to communicate with you. Are you still here with us in this room? Are you still lingering in the afterlife? Girl, help.
Are you in a room?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I heard a yeah. Now, I don't know how accurate this thing is. I'm told it's very accurate by a lot of reputable sources that use it in ghost hunting. Which is why we will be busting out the spirit box later on throughout the night. That was the same woman's voice.
Same woman's voice.
Did you make that noise? Help. Wait, that was a little girl's voice?
Yeah, that was a little girl's voice.
If you guys read up the history about this place, people claim to see a little girl roaming the hallways. Is there a little girl roaming the hallways of this place?
Yeah, that was a clear yes.
That was a clear yes.
That was a clear yes.
What is your name? That was a little... Girl. What is the little girl's name? What was the prostitute's name that died in the closet? Who summoned me?
That was weird. Okay, that was weird.
There was a voice that said, "Who summoned me?" That's very interesting.
What is that?
faucet's dripping again.
I don't hear anything.
Don't say that. It scares me even more.
I actually don't hear anything.
I don't want to be the only one hearing these type of things.
So I've got a camera and a laser aimed at the closet. That's a closet where the decapitated body was found. Oh shit. I just caught an orb, bro. It just came out this way. There's nothing flying around in here. There's no bugs, there's no creatures.
There's no...
I just got another orb coming out of the closet.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
This is too bright, maybe.
Hold on, let me turn off this light. You guys, we have a laser aimed right at the closet where the girl was decapitated. If there is any movement in that closet, the laser grid will catch it. Earlier when I had the laser grid aimed at the closet over there, or that way, I seen something crossing the grid. We don't know what it was. We couldn't see it, but you can see it manipulating the grid.
If there's anybody here, can you please pass by the grid?
If there is anything here with us, please make it known. Show yourself. Stand in front of the laser. Nothing.
Guys, it's getting chilly, so I grabbed my sweater. I showed you the room. We did catch a couple voices on the that app MOE SARGI was using. It did say help like 4 times, off camera and on camera. And I used my black light, and we did catch like, it looked like blood splatters, because like I said in the beginning of the video, there was a female decapitated inside our room, inside the closet. So I don't know if they changed the carpet or it seeped through, but it is just knowing that someone died, 2 people died inside that room that we're about to sleep in tonight. We're gonna sleep in there tonight, and we're definitely gonna record ourselves sleeping. So if you're enjoying this video, it's the only time I gotta say it, smash the thumbs up button. How beautiful and creepy this place is. I'm gonna give you a full... I'm just waiting on Mo to come outside. We're gonna go try to go down to the basement. This place is awesome. They did give us permission to film inside, outside, wherever we can film. And you know, the thing about this place is, this is not just like a typical hotel. This is like a Victorian hotel. Like, everything is old. You only have AC in the room. You don't, and it's like a portable AC. We don't have a heater. Our windows are like padlocked, so people won't, I guess, do something crazy. But another story, second floor, where I might show you. Well, I'll definitely show you, but not right now. Couple months ago, someone committed suicide on the second floor as well. I had no idea. They just told me about this. He hung himself. So I'll definitely pass by second floor all by myself without Mo, and try to contact it and ask it why. So many answers, so many unsolved answers. But yeah, this place is so beautiful. Anyways, guys, next clip, I'm not telling you, but just watch the video. I have no idea where Mo is. I'm beginning to think he's been lost. It's been like 20 minutes. They said I'll meet you outside like in 5 minutes. He's nowhere to be found. And the crazy thing is, all these lights behind me are flickering simultaneously. That's 1, that's 2. That's all the street lights are flickering simultaneously.
That's terrifying. I'm gonna go inside and try to find Mo, because I don't feel safe by myself. And the doors lock at 10 p.m. and it's 10 something. 10:41. So let's see, hopefully the doors are still unlocked. Jonathan, help me in. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
And then I gave you the code for the back door.
Right? Yeah, you did. Thank you so much. I thought I was locked out. Since you're going to stay in the closet, I might as well just kick it here on the bed. I'm going to record myself too then. I don't want to be... I'm scared, man. How do we get the whole room? So guys, we just left the room, and how weird is this? It's literally a chair staring outside. How freaky is this? Like, why would anybody put a chair to sit and go look at maybe the sunset? I don't know, it's freaking me out. All right, let's continue this investigation properly.
Guys, I'm all by myself, all by myself. Moves in the hallway, and I'm gonna try to connect to spirits. I'm gonna go find myself a seat and try to connect with the spirit. Is there anybody here that would like to communicate with me? Can you please make yourself known? Yeah, I'm recording, but the weird thing is that why is there like a newspaper of a...
of a skull.
Of a skull.
Maybe to freak people out or something, I don't know.
Demystifying death, exploring.
I want to show you guys something really, really cool over here. There is this very creepy haunted doll over here.
That's crazy.
The story behind this haunted doll is nobody knows where it's living. Nobody knows who brought it. One day there was
Yo.
A hotel in the hotel, and apparently
there's two of them. So the story goes, there's a lady with a one eye, I think, that stroamed the hallways at nighttime. And hopefully we can contact her. Yo, did you see this piano here?
Yeah, that's nice. It's creepy and nice.
I wonder if it works.
Oh, you know what's funny?
What?
On the clocks, it says, like, almost 1 a.m.
Yeah.
11:30.
That's creepy. This place is so old. And
whoa, what the hell? Whoa.
That was a loud.
Help,
that was a lot of help. That was a help.
Is there anything stuck to this doll? Yes? Is there a spirit attached to the doll?
That was another yes.
That was a lot of yeses.
That was a male yes and a female yes.
How many spirits are attached to this doll? I heard three and leave. Do you have a name?
Haley?
Haley.
Oh, dude.
No, there is no way we just got Haley.
What?
Because a little girl can be seen and heard running throughout the hallways of this place.
Oh my God. Yo, this place is...
So like I said, nobody knows where this doll came from. I'm wondering if there's even a name under there. Wooden doll. Usually these dolls, they have names. I don't see a name anymore.
Yeah, I say we bring it and put it on the table and...
No, I don't want to touch anything that was... That, like, to disturb anything.
That's so freaky.
They have names on the back of them. But is this a female doll? Or a...
I think it's a male or a female little...
I think it looks like a little girl. But we just got a Haley from the spirit box out of this doll.
Yo, what's up with this greyhound? And there's a picture of an actual greyhound here.
Oh, maybe the owner.
Haley, are you here with us now? Did I say yes? The first thing you said is yes?
Haley, are you here? Who's here with us? What the hell?
It said Mo.
No.
That said Mo.
No way.
Rewind that. That said Mo.
No.
That said Mo.
I don't know. A little kid's voice yet again. What do you think we should ask it?
It said Mo.
No, it said Mom. It said Mom.
It said Mom or Mo?
It said Mom a couple times. Do you want your mom? Sit? No.
I'm gonna leave. I can't sit.
No. Let's sit.
I'm about to have a panic attack.
Somebody just told us to sit.
We're sitting by the toys. By the kids' toys.
Yeah. That's very interesting, actually.
That's very terrifying.
So something on the spirit box just told me to sit. Whoever it was that told me to sit, I'm sitting. What now?
Do you plan to hurt us?
Girl.
We keep hearing girls. Did a girl die in the closet upstairs in room 307?
3-8. That was the loudest bang.
That was a loud bang, but did you hear what the spirit box said?
What?
3 a.m. The spirit box literally said 3 a.m. We all know 3 a.m. is the devil's hour. It's when demons and spirits are the most active, because I do believe 3 o'clock in the morning is when demons and spirits, their portals are very active and open. Why 3 a.m.? Well, because 3 p.m. is when Jesus Christ was crucified, and the demons use 3 a.m. as an hour to mock Jesus Christ. I kind of don't even want to activate this thing again.
Yeah, hold on. What is that? Yo, that was so weird. We're at a kid's... This is like a kid's bench with like these kid childish games. Look at here. They got child books. The cat in the hat. Why would they want us to sit here?
So, I don't know if I told you this, but I have the night vision camera rolling in the bedroom, aimed at the closet, hoping we can capture something while we've been away. I want to go at this one more time and see if we can communicate with that kid. I need to know a name. We heard Haley. But is Haley the name of the little kid that died in here? The thing is, there's no stories of a little kid that died in here, but people that do stay here, they complain that they hear kids running around at nighttime.
Yeah.
And they can hear kids laughing and giggling in the middle of the night, near 3 o'clock in the morning, which is crazy. And we did capture 3 a.m. on the spirit box.
Bye.
Hello?
Said bye?
I thought I heard hi. Hey. What's your name? How old are you?
But it sounded like your voice, bro.
It's weird. Do you know my name? Dude, that was a little bit like a little kid crying. That was a little kid moaning or crying. Are there a lot of spirits here with us?
Maybe.
Haley, can you talk to us? We just want to talk to Haley, nobody else.
Said leave.
Haley, we just want to talk to you and nobody else. Should we go back up to our room?
Demon.
Demon, yeah, what the hell? That sounded like demon.
That's a demon.
I really want to know what this demon's name is. If it is really a demon, I'm still not sold on the idea that there's a demon here. But then again, demons do possess people to killing other people and doing bad things.
Does it go outside?
Is there a demon here?
Bro. Did you hear that?
That was a laugh.
It was a little kid either crying or laughing.
I don't know if that was a little kid lying or laughing or crying.
I don't even know if I knocked my own camera down or it fell on its own.
Your camera fell?
Yeah. Bro.
As we just heard a cry for something weird. I'm gonna go at this one more time.
Run? Huh? Did it run?
No, I didn't hear run.
What did you say? What do you want us to do? You told us to sit. What do you want us to do? I'm coming. I heard a voice that said, I'm coming.
Exorcist. It's just an exorcist.
Who's coming? Help. Oh my god, dude.
Bro, I'm
we heard a girl
I have like chills, bro.
We heard a female screaming and saying help. I'm almost wondering if that is the girl that was killed up in the closet.
I don't want to go back up to her
no,
room.
No, let's go. I'm back not... up to the room and see if that was the girl.
Bro, hold on. I'm so scared. Yo, the lights flickered.
What lights?
The lights inside.
Inside where?
That second light just flickered.
If there is anything here right now, can you please make these lights go off and on? Can you move something? Anything we'll do, move something off the shelf. Give us something to work with here. See anything move? Oh, what the hell was that? Did you come see this?
What?
This weird, wet substance on the mirror just appeared out of nowhere. Is that wet?
What?
No, it's not. That's inside the mirror. I don't know. Maybe that was already there. I can't confirm that. That got bigger. The crack definitely got bigger. That wasn't like that before.
Someone trying to break in or something? Yo. Huh. Time. Who closed this door?
I didn't close it.
This door was open. Because I remember using the bathroom last.
Really?
I swear to God.
Oh shit, dude.
Oh, yo! Yo, it just flushed itself.
No, I just saw that. Oh my god, that's gross. The water's moving. That just flushed itself, dude.
That just flushed.
Holy shit, we actually just got that on.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Yo, come over here. You're messing with me, bro.
What?
You did not put that plunger back in there.
Oh! Look, the water's dripping. It's wet. The bathtub is wet. I told you earlier. First of all, what's that? There's some weird.
I don't want to look inside. No!
Dude.
Oh, I'd be scared to take a shit in here.
So here's what my concern is, dude.
What?
Look at this. First of all, that door, I don't believe it was open like that when we left.
Okay.
I've got the night vision rolling over here the entire time, so I want to review that footage.
Yo.
And that's kind of concerning me.
Are those handprints on the bed? Or am I tripping out?
I don't know. What's that noise? There's something walking in here.
What was that?
Haley?
Haley, if that was you, can you please make a sound?
Haley, is that you walking in here? So that clock right there, that's not accurate. It's definitely not accurate. It's definitely not 12:55. It's almost 2 o'clock in the morning right now. What's going on in here right now, dude? I'm feeling weird.
Bro, not only am I feeling weird, I feel like we're being watched.
Right?
It does feel like there is some type of presence in here with us right now.
Definitely.
But it doesn't feel evil. I don't know. But we did hear demon on the spirit box. I'm kind of wanting to turn on that spirit box once more.
Warn me. That scared the hell out of me.
Hello, Haley, are you here? Haley, are you here?
I see you!
No!
Oh my God!
Behind you. That was behind you.
Oh my God!
I freaked out because I just seen a vision of something standing behind me. Holy shit.
Bro, I see like blue and red lights. I don't know what if I have something messing with my
head. Let's go in the closet, bro.
Bro!
Let's go in the closet together. Let's go in the closet together right now.
Oh, I'm so scared. What if we get locked in here?
Hold on. Was that you?
Please.
What? Who's here with us right now? Haley or some type of demon?
Haley! What the fuck? We just got Haley on the spirit box, you guys. You guys just heard that loud and clear.
We're not fooling around here. There's nothing. We're not messing around, guys. We just got Haley again.
Twice.
Haley, if you are here, please give us a sign.
Bro, I feel lightheaded in here, bro.
Haley, did you die in this room? Is that your real name? Do you have dowsing rods?
I have dowsing rods.
Let's get those dowsing rods out and maybe we can see if there's some type of presence in here.